Homemade guacamole. Life hack. Okay, today we are making my homemade famous guacamole. I guess it's famous only in the Carpenter household. Other people seem to like it. I have done a few of the avocados. So I'm just going to show you how I get the avocado out of this half, give it a good slice down the center several times, and then take it by the side and quarter it. Try not to cut yourself. Give it a good squeeze. These aren't the best avocados in ripeness. And then you've got your guts in the bowl. So I've done this several times, but I'm going to go through and do this last one. Cut it in half. Give it a good twist. Now some people do the old, you know, karate chop, but I've cut myself way too many times. So I usually just use my spoon to get the pit out. To be on the safe side of not cutting myself, drop it into the bowl. Again, ooh, this one's good. Nice and soft. And then we're gonna cut across. We're gonna get all the guts out. Voila. Get the other side. Don't cut all the way through and cut your hand off. Back down the other side. And get all the guts out. This avocado is actually nice and soft and perfect. Okay. So we got all of our goods in the bowl. Then we're going to take our pico de gallo. Now you can chop up tomatoes and onions and dump it in. I do it the life hack way, just buy it. Now, keto it all. Best gift, best invention ever made is the masher. I've given this lecture to my kids so many times. If you don't have a masher in your house, highly recommend. This is the only thing you need when raising children is a good masher. I'm gonna get these pits out of here. Don't ever, 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 ever buy baby food. A masher is all you need. If you want to feed them bananas, get your masher out and mash up bananas. If you want to feed them some peas, get your masher out. Mash up some peas. If you want to feed them green beans, get your masher out and mash up some green beans. It's the same damn thing as what you buy in a jar. Carrots, mash up some carrots. Same damn thing. Hell of a lot cheaper than buying all that crap in a jar. So we're gonna mash all this up. Best utensil I ever bought. Probably cost me about $1. Guacamole aesthetically is not the most aesthetically looking substance in the world, but it tastes amazing. I'm gonna get this all mashed up. This is what gets all the flavors all in together. Now, takes a little people power. When you do this with good, fresh, ripe avocados, it's a little less people power because they just mash right up. Some people like their avocados, their guacamole, a little chunky. Spot one. Now, to taste, we're going to add bigger chunks, get them good. Now, the thing we like to do at our house is add some fresh cherry tomatoes. Save your pits because you're going to add those back in, because those keep your guacamole fresh. So we're going to add a bunch of fresh tomatoes. Little tomatoes are a little bit longer than what we normally get. Because later we got a taco bar going on. This is just the appetizer. We got some chicken in the crock pot, shredded for our taco bar later. This also adds to the aesthetic, to the pleasing eye, makes the guacamole a little more inviting to eat. Then we're going to hit it with the last thing, one fresh it a little. Taste test. Break.
Hits the spot. Right on. Right on. That's it. Oh my God.